Good morning, students. In our previous video, we have discussed about causes of diseases, and we have seen that there are internal as well as external factors which causes infectious diseases. In this video, we are going to discuss about means of spread of infectious diseases. So, infectious diseases, as we know, are spread from one infected person to other normal person by a variety of method. So, infectious diseases are spread through air. For example, common cold, pneumonia, and tuberculosis. Such disease-causing microbes are spread basically through the air. This occurs through the little droplets thrown out by an infected person who sneezes or coughs. So, whenever we sneeze or cough, the tiny droplets which comes out of the mouth of infected person causes these airborne diseases. So someone standing close by can breathe in these droplets and the microbes get chance to start a new infection by entering the body of a normal person. So that's why it was always said that whenever we sneeze or cough, we should always put a cloth or hanky or hand in front of our mouth so that the tiny droplets are not breathed up by the person standing near to the infected person. Infectious diseases can also be spread by water. So waterborne diseases are basically cholera, dysentery, etc. So infectious diseases can also spread through the water, and basically this occurs when we drink contaminated water. So if we drink contaminated water, then these waterborne diseases, we get these waterborne diseases like cholera and dysentery. Now, infectious diseases can also spread through vectors. So many animals which live with us may carry diseases, and vectors are basically the carriers of diseases or infection. So these animals carry the infecting agents from a sick person to another healthy person. So thus these animals act as an intermediators, or we can say the vectors. So vectors are the carrier of a disease or infection. For example, mosquitoes are a vector of disease called malaria. Also, house flies is a carrier of various diseases like typhoid, tuberculosis, cholera, dysentery, etc. So, infectious diseases can also be spread through vectors. Last but not the least, these diseases can also be spread through sexual contact. For example, syphilis, which is basically a bacterial infection usually spread by sexual contact that starts as a painless sore, and AIDS, you all know, that acquired immune deficiency syndrome, which is basically caused by a virus, HIV virus. So both of these pathogens are transmitted by sexual contact from one partner to the another. Other than sexual contacts, AIDS virus can also spread through blood to blood contact, or we can say that blood transfusion, use of common needles and syringes. So AIDS virus can also be spread through blood transfusion from infected to a healthy person. Also, an infected mother can spread this disease to her baby through breastfeeding or during the pregnancy. Now let us discuss the contacts that do not spread AIDS. So AIDS is not a contagious disease and it does not spread by casual contacts. So these sexually transmitted diseases are not spread by casual physical contact, and casual physical contacts includes these handshakes, hugs, sports such as wrestling, or by any of the other way in which we touch each other socially, like shaking hands, in coughing, sneezing, kissing, sharing utensils, in swimming pools, sharing towels. So by these casual contacts, AIDS are not spread through. So it basically spread through the sexual contact from one partner to the other, not by the casual physical contact. So I hope this topic, means of spread of infectious diseases, is clear to you. So basically these infectious diseases are spread through air, water, vectors and sexual contact. So that's it for today. In the next video, we are going to continue with our chapter.